It's Friday, February 8th, 2019. My name is Abriana.
And I'm Giselle.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'm a peacemaker. I pledge to recognize the good people do to make positive choices and help others to do the same. I will build peace at school, at home, and in my community every day.
Lunch for today will be taco, turkey, carrots, pears, lettuce, and cheese, and whole grain tortilla and milk.
Sounds fantastic. Now for our Harrison birthdays. Today, Darnese Tate has a birthday. On Saturday, Leonardo Mariano has a birthday. Happy birthday to all of you. Attention 3rd through 5th graders. Our author, Tricia Springstub, visit has been rescheduled for the afternoon of February 14th.
If you would like to order a signed copy of a book, there is still time. Extra forms are available in the LRC, are due February 12th. Also, you know attendance is super important here at Harrison because if you are not here, you can't learn here.
In every school year, there are two semesters. The first semester went from the first day of school all the way to December 20th, which was the last day before winter break.
And guess what? There are 74 students who got perfect attendance in the first semester.
What do we mean by perfect attendance?
Well, it means that you were at school every day and that you didn't have any more than 4 tardies.
And if you had perfect attendance, you got a certificate and a treat.
Together, Harrison had 74 students with perfect attendance. Check it out.
Okay, here we come to the rescue. Yeah. We're the best, it don't matter what the rest do. Okay. All of you evil guys, we're gonna get you. If you fall down, I'll stretch out and catch you. Living the life of a super. Jack Jazz got the eyes that'll shoot ya. Stand back and we might just move ya. Running so fast that we fly to the future.
Oh, the next move cleverly. Rather high, living you can't see. We got strength that you won't believe. About to get so cold that your fingers freeze you.
Here to save the day, we gonna rock it like we used to do.
If you try to stop us, then you better know we never lose. It's time to make some wrong things right. We here to lead this fight to an incredible night.
Come on.
Let's get started. Looks like an incredible night.
Wow, good job to all of you. This is Tule Wa with the weather. We are moving into a cold front. Yesterday we saw a high of 61 degrees, but today will only be 28. We will have partly sunny skies. I predict there are 89% chances of outdoor recess. Saturday will be a repeat of today. On Sunday, we may see slightly warmer temperatures, but you can also expect to see some snow. As always, be sure to dress for the weather and make a wonderful weather day. Let's go over to Adrian with an incredible information.
Good morning. Today we are going to talk about salt. Salt is so important. When it is icy, we can use it outside on the roads and sidewalks to melt the ice. We also put it in our food to add flavor. And you probably know this, but all our oceans are made up of salt water. That means that 3.5% of ocean is salt. There are lots of different kinds of salt, like table salt, kosher salt, and rock salt. If you look at them through a microscope, you can see that the crystals that make up the salt are all different sizes. Because the crystals are all shaped differently, a tablespoon of table salt weighs more than a tablespoon of kosher salt. Whenever you cook with salt, you can always taste your food to make sure that you have the right amount of salt. Next week, we will show you a cool thing that you can do with salt. As always, you can learn more about and incredible stuff in your Harrison Library. And now, I think we have a special Black History Month piece.
Florence Dolores Griffith Joyner, also known as FloJo, was an American track and field athlete. She is considered the fastest woman of all time based on the fact that the world record she set in 1988 for both the 100-meter and 200-meter still stand. During the late 1980s, she became a popular figure in international track and field because of her record-setting performances and flashy personal style. Griffith Joyner was born and raised in California. She was athletic from a young age.
Thank you. Now for a joke to end our newscast. Why do fish live in salt water?
That's a good question. Why do fish live in salt water?
Because pepper makes them sneeze.
our superpower is we come to school. How about you? Let's all be incredible too. We hope you have an incredible weekend.
This is Abriana,
Giselle,
Tulewa,
and Adrian.
Signing off. The news is in and we are out.